In this video, I'm going to talk about how I became ADHD, no purpose in life, Netflix every day, zero confidence, and socially awkward to now who I am. And I'm going to be completely honest, okay? Completely honest, no hiding in my journey, in my life. And then I'm going to be sharing this to you guys, hoping that this will encourage you guys to make a change in your life. Welcome to my channel. My name is Show, and I'm going to talk about myself. I'm going to seem very, very self-centered and ridiculous, but I want you guys to know that I want you guys to know who I really was and who I really am right now. The reason why I decided to do this is because nowadays we only see people on social media, right? And we don't get to know who they really are and who they really was, what kind of life they had. I mean, it's a very personal thing to share, obviously, but like I said, I'm hoping that my journey and how I didn't have a confidence, how I was depressed, and then how I was socially awkward and lazy bastard back in the days to actually transform into who I am right now and traveling around the world and running my own business and just being happy every day. So let's get started. So, I was born in Tokyo as an only child, so I didn't know anything about sharing things with people. I didn't know how to share things with people, friends, till I met my best friend in high school. And he taught me how to share things, and he taught me a lot of things when I was 16, 17, 18. And in my junior high school, I was like 13, 14, I was bullied, and I think most of the school hated me because I was a jerk, and I understand that, but I was different. I was different than other kids, And of course, if you're different, then people can't handle it. And so that kind of makes sense to me, and which I really appreciate. I really appreciate all these kids, you know, to bully me and like the people who didn't give a shit about me, who literally hated me and talk about shit about me in the back. Because that experience made me stronger and made me a person who can understand other people's pain, and which I really appreciate it. And then I went through this process that I forgive them, I forgave them, and then I faced them and dealt with it. Went into meditation, and I literally couldn't see my face when I was that age because I hated myself. And I hated to go to school, and I hated everything. But the only thing that kept me alive was basketball. I played basketball for like more than 10 years. And then to play basketball every single day kept me alive. And that was the only thing that I really enjoyed in my life, like 5-6 years, I guess. And when I was young, I was actually pretty extrovert, like really extroverted kid. And I go up to the kid and make some funny faces and trying to make a joke, and I was always getting attention. I was only a child, I loved getting attentions from people. And then because of that experience, I basically became such an introvert, and I started to act like a calm person, very cool, and then I talk less, and very, very silent kid. I think the character that we have, the character of who we are, but here's the thing, we all born as a consciousness, right? So because we are the consciousness, we are the awareness itself. And the personality is made up with how you think and how you feel and how you act. But you can change it, so you can literally become a different person. Your character is actually something that you're born with, is something the core of yourself, you know, like you can't change that. Okay, this is what I like, this is what I'm passionate about. This is something that very characteristic, which the personality comes on the top of the character. And so my character was very, very extroverted, and I love teaching, I love communicating with people, I love getting attentions, and I just love talking, right? So since that experience, I became really introvert and talking less and less and less. And after the graduation of high school, since when I was 19, I started traveling around. I went to London and New York and Los Angeles, and yeah, I went a lot of them in the vacations because I wanted to learn English and I wanted to live abroad. That's something that I knew from the beginning. So when I was 21, I went to London for 6 months. And that changed my life. That was the life-changing experience for me, that decision that I made. And I really appreciated myself. And I started modeling when I was in London. And afterwards, here's what's gonna happen. So I started trying out as a model and I went to New York. And then in New York, I couldn't just handle myself looking at these white beautiful boys and black beautiful boys, like even taller than me, and blue eyes and beautiful skin and beautiful everything. And I just started comparing myself to them. You know, I wanted to be like them. So I started to feel like a lot more negative, and I built that such a strong negative neural pathway in my brain. So all I think about is so negative. Everything is so negative. It's basically that depression is the ultimate version of the negative habits, negative thoughts and negative feelings. And then eventually you get into this spiral because your thoughts and feelings are connected. So when you think about something negative, you trigger the feelings, the emotions that relate to that negative thought, which is basically negative, sad, or like insecure, come across these relating thoughts and feelings and then go in a spiral. So I was so depressed. And I was drinking every day, I was also smoking weed. And yeah, I just wanted to have fun and get laid. And that was it, like nothing else. And also I created this illusion, which is fear. And when I was in New York, you know, there's so many beautiful ladies, beautiful women in New York. I also created this mindset that the fear, the illusion in my brain, in my head, which is like, oh, I'm not good enough because first of all, I'm fucking Asian and look at these macho, beautiful boys in New York. They're so well communicated and they're just, everything they do is fucking better than me. So I just created that fucking in my head, and it created different self-images and different identity and different everything, which so fucking negative. But basically everything you do is like you think about something negative, you think about your self-images as a worthless Asian coward, lazy guy, right? And I went back to Japan, right, after New York, and people treat me different. Because I speak English, first of all, and not so many Japanese people can't speak English because of the education system. And then so in Japan, I started working as a model, obviously, and then I was a model at the time. Because of the mindset that I created, because of the neural pathway that I created, the self-images, the identity I created in Japan. Okay, I'm going to be honest with this guy, because I had this thought that, okay, I might be good looking, and I don't know why these people get jobs. And I'm like, It is fucking ridiculous. I'm telling you, it's fucking ridiculous. I was thinking that why I don't get jobs, then why these people get jobs? And then that's really, really bad because you already created that I don't get a job. Like I created my reality that I don't get a job and my self-image is like, I'm not good enough and then I'm, of course I'm not good enough because I'm not doing anything, right? Like I was hitting the gym like twice a week and it's fucking nothing. So I was doing nothing, but then my thought was like jealousy, envy, and so much negativity, and it was a chaos. It was literally a chaos. And then in Japan, like I said, I was comparing myself to others. And then I created myself like, I don't get a fucking job. And then I was always thinking about other people, other people, other people. And that was like my me, 23, 24, right? And I was just going to partying and getting drunk. And yeah, that was it. Like singing karaoke and shit. And I was waking up like 10 a.m. And I wasn't working like 6-7 days. I was working like four days or something, and I'm like, oh, I'm so tired. I was always tired. For what? For no reason. Because I created that. I created my energy level. I determined my energy level so that's the energy you get. Always thinking about it. The moment that I wake up, I start thinking about the problems. I start thinking about, oh shit, my life is fucking boring. when I'm in Japan, it's fucking boring. So everything that I was thinking about myself, about people, about life, was something negative. But then, this is what happened. I met my mentor, his name is Hiro. He's still a model, but he also teach people how to walk. He teach models and the people who's not modeling how to create the body shape and how to walk properly. I was taking his lessons for the walking, and then he actually just randomly just put the meditation for the first 5 minutes. And I was like, oh, I've heard of the meditation. It's like a Buddhism thing, like a Zen thing, right? And so basically he set the alarm for 5 minutes, and then we sat on the floor and we meditated for 5 minutes. I couldn't focus for fucking 5 seconds. Like, chaos. I was thinking about five things at the same time. Five fucking things at the same time. I was thinking about, oh my god, my body hurts, my legs hurts, my back hurts, and then it's hurt, like what time is it, like how long it has been, and like, do I look cool in my meditation? Stupid things and chaos. And then just that moment I realized, does people do the same thing? Is it just me thinking about five fucking things at the same time, or is it just, or everyone does that? And then, okay, I decided to meditate every single day after he told me how to meditate. So I meditate for 5 minutes with headspace, with the guiding meditation. And then I did for every single night. And my mom sometimes, my mom actually came upstairs because I was living my parents' house at the time. And she just came out and then like, what the fuck are you doing? And I was like, meditating. And then I said, meditating. You know, like, I was only a child, it was overprotective, she was anxious, everything about what I do. Even I started reading books when I was 23, I love books, but I couldn't read books before when I was 23, and I started reading about acting books, and because I was really interested in, I was taking acting lessons as well. So I started to read books and then ordering Amazon and stuff, and she was like, why are you reading fucking books? And I was like, you love books. She loves books. She's like a dictionary. My favorite book's a dictionary type of woman. And she's got like a whole bunch of books in the massive drawer. But then when I started reading, and she was like, are you crazy? That's my mom. That's who she is, okay? So I started reading books when I was 23 or something, and I meditated every single night. And then even after my mom came up and like freaked out, I started to develop the skill of focus, the ability of focus, and an ability to be present. And that, my friend, was a life-changing decision, which since I did in London. So I did in a month, I could focus for 15 minutes. I could just sit, meditate, and then my third eye was already open at the time, so I could start seeing light and movement, and my body was just like heating up, and then I felt really, really warm. And at that time was the first spiritual awakening that I had in my meditation. That was enlightenment that I experienced. And I could easily hold 20 minutes for no, like, whatsoever. Like, my thought was super solid, and I was so happy. I was smiling, thinking about nothing. I was completely emptiness, and I hit that level of my mind to, like, thinking about five things at the same time, 5 seconds focus in a couple months. Like I said, that was the second life-changing decision that I made. And then I started changing internally. And then I came to Amsterdam 2 years ago, which when I was 26. And I learned so many things before. I learned so many things, self-development and meditation, spirituality and Buddhism and Zen, so many things. And I was so ready to make another life-changing decision in Amsterdam, which was a life-changing decision for me, because here's what's gonna happen. When you start to make a change in your life, you start to see the dots. You start to see the dots, like, everywhere. But it doesn't make sense to you until if it's just a bunch of dots. But when it becomes a line and it created to some shape, that, my friend, is the next step That is the next level of awareness that you can experience. Because when it's stopped, you have no idea. You learn this and that and these, that, and then you see dots. But then you have some questions in your head, and you have something that is not completely satisfied in you. And you'd be like, oh, what is it? Then it becomes the shape. And then you'd be like, oh, this is what it is. This is what I didn't understand. This is what I didn't see it. And then your awareness become more pure and clear. And you realize so many things because now it's creating shape. And there's another one, which I'm going to talk later. And I came to Amsterdam and so many things. And then I started to study every single day. And then at the same time, I started to run or start this business, which is my company. It's called Theater, Live Your Life Like a Movie. You know, like we only live once. We only live once and then we can't change that. We came to this planet to die, right? Which is very, very interesting because we are so afraid to die even though we came here to eventually die. In the self-development, everything you can name, I did that. I did that consistently. I did cold shower for like a week and then I ended up like taking a cold shower for like 3, 6, 5, only cold shower, 1 year challenge, which was a long journey. And I did the 30 days everyday workout challenge, which became my routine. I work out every single day still. Tried it out like so many meditation, right? Like the first I was just like breathing in and breathing out, like focus on mindfulness type of meditation. But I found out like so many meditations, so I tried everything and I was still in my head. And I didn't know why. I didn't know why I'm still fucking in my head. I do everything that I could find in a self-development and I was still doing the everything, right? And then I was still in my head and I was like, okay, I give up. I don't know what to do. And in that time, the business that I launched was with my best friends. Every single one of us was literally burned out, and then we spent so much money because we were working every single day and creating YouTube and workshop and everything. It was horrible. I was so frustrated every day and I couldn't control anything, any aspect of myself. So they left and we decided to do different things. You know what people see in the social media ain't life, okay? This is what I learned in Malta. It doesn't fucking matter where you are. You think it does matter. But look, I was in Milan and Amsterdam and Milan and Malta. It was phenomenal. I fucking loved it. I fucking loved the lifestyle, which I manifested it. But then when I was in Malta, I realized it doesn't matter because I was happy in Milan, I was happy in Amsterdam, and I'm happy in Malta. It's not because Malta makes me happy. It's not like that. You are happy, that's why you enjoy Malta. You're happy, that's why you enjoy where you are. You're happy, that's why you become even happier in the relationship. It's not relying on something makes you happy. It's a decision that you make. And then maybe it might be a hard time to decide to be happy. But it is really a decision. The moment, being present, being grounded, okay, I decide to be happy right now. And it's okay to be sad, it's okay to feel, because we are the emotional creature, we have feelings and emotions, and then that is a beautiful thing. That's why we can, you know, that is why there's a word with empathy and sympathy. We can resonate with people, and that is a beautiful thing. That's how we connect. Human to human, we connect emotionally. That's a relationship, right? Friendship, everything. It's connection. It's a very, very emotional thing, and emotion is energy, emotion. So we connect with energy because we are made of energy. And the last transformation that I experienced in Malta was that dot. Dots became a line. The dots became a line and then created a shape for me. And now, it's an object. It became a 3D. It was a line. It was a line, and then I could see the shape, you know, like a triangle. You know, I don't know what kind of shape it is, but it's like you're looking at the stars. But now, I could see the star itself. So which means there's a depth, and there's on the back, and it's just object. And I think there's another layer of the transformation. Look, you can learn so many things. You can become smarter and smarter and smarter with YouTube and books and someone else's knowledge. And that's how you learn. But you can't be wiser with someone else's knowledge. You can only be wiser with your own experience. And that's what we need. That's what we need. And I want you guys to know that self-love is not about looking in a mirror and I'm good enough. You know, looking in a mirror and then like, it's okay to be like this. It's okay to look like this. If you want to change, if you want to love yourself, because think about it, if you love someone, your family, your friends, your dogs and cats, you would do anything for them. You will be there for them. You support them, cheer them up so that they can fucking stand up and accomplish their goals. That's the self-love. That's the love. You become love itself. And why loving self is so different than loving others? Self-love is about helping yourself, supporting yourself. Be there for yourself so that you can accomplish your goals. You can enjoy your life. And that is a self-love. There is so many ideas out there, and then I think it's bullshit. Because all these people just loving themselves, eating potato chips, not working out, and looking in the mirror, then it's okay. If you want to improve something, then do it. But if you're so happy with your body, with your images, with who you are, then you're good to go. That's a difference. That's a difference. If you're so happy with yourself, then that's okay. But if you want to change something in your life, then you have to change things in your life. Then otherwise, nothing will change. With that said, thank you so much, guys, for watching. I really appreciate you guys. Because without you guys who supporting me, sending me a DM and watching my YouTube and TikTok and Instagram, it's supporting me too. Because I love inspiring others, I love helping others, and I love teaching them. That was my character. I also feel fulfilled by doing this. And really appreciate you guys for, you know, supporting me and showing me love. So I just want you guys to know that you appreciate it. All right. I'll see you in the next video. Ciao. Live your life like a movie.